गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. एक्चुअली वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टुडे वेव नेचर ऑफ मैटर. बिफोर दिस वी आर ट्राइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड द पोस्टुलेट्स ऑफ बोर्स एटॉमिक मॉडल. सो इन अर्लियर क्लासेस वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड, बट अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज. द फर्स्ट पोस्टुलेट वॉज एटम हैज सेंटर कॉल्ड न्यूक्लियस. For example, consider the cell and this is the center. So according to first postulates, this is called nucleus. The second postulate was electron revolves only in fixed circular orbit with fixed energy and fixed velocity. For example, this is the cells around the nucleus. So electron can only revolve in the fixed cell. Sometimes it is called KLM or M. The third postulate was there was condition of the electron revolving. The condition was that electron revolves only in those circular orbit where the angular momentum is integral multiple of nh upon 2 pi. Electron will revolve in fixed cell, but condition is that the angular momentum, this is denoted by L, should be integral multiple of h upon 2 pi, h upon 2 pi, where n is integer 1, 2, 3, 4, up to so on. So if this condition will be there, then we can say the electron will revolve in that particular cell. The fourth postulate was electron revolving the around the nucleus, so electrostatic force, we can understand by this figure. For example, this is the center called nucleus and this is the radius r, and here the electron is there, okay, in nth cell, okay. So electrostatic force at the center, it is provided by centrifugal force. So centripetal force at center gives centrifugal force, and it is between nucleus and electron. So here is electron, here is nucleus. And in the nucleus, there are proton and neutron. So electrostatic force between electron and nucleus, it gives centrifugal force. That's why electrons revolving around the nucleus and it does not come at the center. So this is the fourth postulate. Five postulate was there. While revolving of electron in a particular orbit or particular cell can neither lose energy nor gain energy. For example, if this is a cell, so in this particular cell, electron can neither lose energy nor gain energy. So this is the fifth postulate. एंड लास्ट बट नॉट द लिस्ट सिक्स पोस्टुलेट इज देयर कि इफ वी गिव एनर्जी टू दैट इलेक्ट्रॉन दैट पार्टिकुलर एनर्जी विल बी गिवन टू दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन देन इट विल जंप टू इस नेक्स्ट लेवल ऑफ सेल. सो दिस इज द फिक्स पोस्टुलेट. इफ यू विल सी सो देयर विल बी लेस एनर्जी देयर विल बी मोर देयर विल बी मच मोर एंड देयर विल बी इन्फिनिटी. सो इफ यू गिव सम एनर्जी इन दिस पार्टिकुलर ऑर्बिट सो दिस विल जम्प टू नेक्स्ट सेल. सो दिस वॉज द पॉस्टुलेट ऑफ बेसिकली बोर एटोमिक मॉडल. बट देयर इज सम फेलियर ऑफ बोर एटोमिक मॉडल एंड दैट्स वाई मिस्टर डी ब्रॉगली सजेस्टेड फ्यू थिंग्स अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रॉन और यू कैन से अबाउट द मैटर. सो वी विल सी टूडे दिस टॉपिक. सो मेन टॉपिक इज टूडे वेव नेचर ऑफ मैटर. There are two things need to be understood. First is light and second is electron. Up to today, as far as concern our class, we know light is wave and electron is particle. So you may raise a question, so why light is only wave and why electron is only particle? Light is only wave because it cannot be transmitted from one part to another part, that's why it is wave. Whereas in particle you can physically transform the energy from one part to another part. But de Broglie suggested light is not only a wave, it is also a particle. And electron is not only particle, it is also wave. So in summarize, he has suggested any particle or light which is moving will having dual nature. This word is very important, dual nature. Dual means two nature. What is two? One is wave and another is particle. So we will know how he has suggested and rather J.J. Thomson also proven, and for that he has been given a Nobel Prize. So how he has suggested, let us see. So you can write down first of all what is the de Broglie hypothesis. De Broglie hypothesis, and it is like that all particles such as electron, photon, proton, light, molecules is having dual nature. Dual nature, that is wave and particle. Whenever these particles आर कंटिन्यूअसली मूविंग. All particles such as electron, photon, proton, light, molecules is having dual nature, that is wave and particle, whenever these particles are continuously moving. So this is the basic hypothesis of de Broglie. So please write down this and we will move forward. Okay. We will see two things. First is particle and second is wave. To being a particle, there are two conditions. It should having some mass and velocity, and it must be accelerated like us, like a train, like a bus. If you give a force having some mass and velocity, so it will move. And for wave, there should be three things, that is, it should have wavelength, wave length, it is denoted by lambda. This should have frequency, it is denoted by f, and it should have some angular velocity, it is denoted by v. So we will see how electron is having wave as well as particle nature. So if electron is having wave nature, so it must have some wavelength. So how it will come? So de Broglie hypothesis, why this word is being used? This is also important. Hypothesis means somewhat suggestion. There is no experimental proof what de Broglie has suggested. That's why it is hypothesis, means his personal suggestion about the electron. That was, it is known as hypothesis. So what he suggested? Electron is made up of teeny particles. Teeny particles. And it is called photon. It is called photon. So electron is made up of teeny particles, small particles. It is called photon. And whenever it surrounds the nucleus, then it emits some energy. It emits some energy. So there is a mass energy equation, E is equal to mc square, according to Einstein. So energy can be converted into mass, and mass can be converted into energy. On the basis of this principle, he has suggested electron is having wave and particle nature. So if this is a energy, so E is equal to h into f, where E is energy, h is Planck's constant, and f is frequency. If you change the energy level with some different frequency, so we can write E1 is equal to HF1, E2 is equal to HF2 and up to so on. So energy, since Planck constant is constant, it will not change. So energy is totally depend upon frequency. Whenever you will change the frequency, the energy level will change. Energy level will change. So what is V? That is velocity, h into lambda, where V is velocity and lambda is wavelength. Lambda is wavelength. So you can find out the frequency. Frequency will be V upon lambda. So if you put this frequency value in this equation, what you will get? E is equal to hc by lambda, where you can see this c is nothing but it is v. But why it is written as a c? Because c is the velocity of light. So E is equal to hc upon lambda, where h is Planck's constant, and this lambda is wavelength. Consider light. So what is the speed of light? What is the speed of light? So speed of light and speed of electron is nearly same. Speed of light is something 10 raised to 8 meter per second, and this is somewhat 10 raised to 6 meter per second. So at a particular point, this light can be behaves like an electron. So earlier light was a wave and electron was a particle, but as far as concern this equation, the electrons behaves like a light. So the electron can have not only particle nature but also wave nature. So this is the proven by this equation. Energy is equal to hc upon lambda. Energy is equal to hc upon lambda, and the electron will having both particle and wave nature. Consider an electron having mass and velocity. So what will be momentum? Momentum. This momentum is equal to mass into velocity, and lambda is equal to h upon momentum, that is h upon m into v. So this equation, is nothing but de Broglie equation डी ब्रॉगली इक्वेशन एंड दिस पार्टिकुलर वेवलेंथ इज नोन एज डी ब्रॉगली वेवलेंथ. सो फ्रॉम दिस इक्वेशन यू कैन ईजिली अंडरस्टैंड द इलेक्ट्रॉन इज हैविंग पार्टिकल एंड वेव नेचर. हाउ इट इज, दिस इज अ वेवलेंथ. सो वेवलेंथ इज रिलेटेड विथ वेव नेचर एंड द पार्टिकल इज हैविंग मास एंड वेलोसिटी दैट इज कॉल्ड मोमेंटम. दिस इज अ पार्टिकल नेचर. दिस इज अ पार्टिकल नेचर. सो दिस इक्वेशन शोज दैट इलेक्ट्रॉन इज हैविंग बोथ वेव एंड पार्टिकल नेचर. वन अदर थिंग ही हैज ऑल्सो सजेस्टेड कि इट इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल फॉर बिग पार्टिकल्स. फॉर बिग पार्टिकल्स दिस वेव एंड पार्टिकल नेचर दैट इज कॉल्ड ड्यूअल नेचर इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल. इट इज एप्लीकेबल ओनली फॉर ए स्मॉल, ओनली फॉर ए स्मॉल पार्टिकल्स एंड इट इज कॉल्ड माइक्रोस्कोपिक. माइक्रोस्कोपिक पार्टिकल्स. सो अनदर पॉइंट इज दैट यू कैन राइट डाउन, यू कैन राइट डाउन डी ब्रॉगलीज इक्वेशन इज एप्लीकेबल ओनली फॉर माइक्रोस्कोपिक पार्टिकल्स. यू कैन से मूविंग पार्टिकल्स. माइक्रोस्कोपिक मूविंग पार्टिकल्स. डी ब्रॉगलीज इक्वेशन इज एप्लीकेबल ओनली फॉर माइक्रोस्कोपिक मूविंग पार्टिकल्स. हाउ इट इज वी विल सी एन एग्जाम्पल. फॉर एग्जाम्पल कंसिडर यू आर हैविंग अ क्रिकेट बॉल. You can say this is a bigger particle, big particle having some weight, okay, and here there is an electron. So for cricket ball, for example, generally mass of cricket ball is how much? Consider 100 gram. If you will throw this ball with a speed of 20 meter per second, so in this case what will be wavelength? Wavelength will be h upon m into v. So what is Planck's constant? 6.626 into 10 raised to minus 34 joule second upon 100 gram is the mass and 20 is the velocity. So you will get this will be 3.313 into 10 raised to minus 44 meter. And if you will convert it into angstrom, so it will be 3.313 into 10 raised to minus 34 angstrom. This is very, very, very small value. यू कैन नॉट मेजर दिस, यू कैन नॉट मेजर दिस, दैट्स वाई दिस क्रिकेट बिल बॉल विल नॉट हैव वेव लेंथ, सो दिस इज ओनली पार्टिकल, दिस इज ओनली पार्टिकल बिकॉज यू कैन नॉट मेजर द वेव लेंथ. इफ यू थ्रो दिस बॉल विथ अ स्पीड ऑफ 20 मीटर पर सेकेंड हैविंग अ मास ऑफ 100 ग्राम, सो द वेव लेंथ ऑफ दिस क्रिकेट बॉल इज एज स्मॉल एज यू कैन नॉट मेजर, दैट्स वाई यू कैन से दिस क्रिकेट बॉल इज हैविंग पार्टिकल नेचर. इट विल ऑल्सो विल हैव वेव नेचर प्रोवाइडेड इट विल हैव टू बी थ्रो विथ वेरी वेरी हायर स्पीड, देन यू कैन से दिस विल हैव पार्टिकल वेव नेचर ऑल्सो एज फार एज कंसर्न दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन. सो व्हाट इज द मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, व्हाट विल द मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इज 9.1 × 10⁻³⁴ kg. And what is the velocity? Velocity is 2.18 × 10⁸ meter per second. And you will find out the wavelength. So this will be h upon m into v. By putting the value of h, 6.626 × 10⁻³⁴ divided by 9.1 × 10⁻³⁴ × 2.18 × 10⁸. So you will get this value like 3.2 × 10⁻¹⁰ meter per second meter, and this will be 3.2 angstrom, and which is measurable. You can measure this wavelength. As compared to this wavelength is very very big. So this can be measured. This can be measured, that's why we can say this electron will have a wave nature, and it is also having particle nature because it is having mass and velocity. So by this example you can easily understand that microscopic particles will have both particle and wave nature. Okay, you can take another example also on the place of cricket ball. You can take another thing also while having some mass and velocity is very less. Okay, we will see a example. It can also be asked in a question paper. So we will see a example, then we will finish this chapter. What is the question? Question. An electron, a alpha particle, and a proton. There are three things: electron, alpha particle, and a proton has same kinetic energy. So arrange them in order to, in order to its decreasing order of wavelength. So first of all, you will have to understand the question. What is question? There are three small particles, electron, alpha particle and a proton. What is the condition? Is having same kinetic energy. So arrange these particles in order to its decreasing order of wavelength. Means you will have to calculate the wavelength, and this has to be arranged in decreasing order of its wavelength. So you will have to find out the wavelength of all particles and have to be arranged. So for this you will have to understand the relation between lambda, that is wavelength, and kinetic energy. Unless and until you will not get the formula between lambda, that is wavelength, and kinetic energy, you cannot solve this question. So how it will? So we know lambda is equal to h upon p, where p is momentum. And what is kinetic energy? Kinetic energy is half mv square. So, for example, this kinetic energy can be written as a K, can be written like this, mv into v. And if momentum is m into v, so what is v? p upon m. So this can be written like this, 1 by 2 into p upon m, that is equal to k. So k will be how much? P square upon 2 into m, and p can be written as under root 2 m k. This momentum can be written as under root 2 m k. So now you are having the momentum in terms of kinetic energy. Now let us put the value of momentum in this equation. So how much you will get? Lambda is equal to h upon 2 m into k. Now where k is kinetic energy, m is the mass, and h is Planck's constant. Now you can understand there will be fixed value of h, that is fixed. Kinetic energy of all these three particles is same. So what is the variable part? That is m. 2 is also fixed. In that case you can write down lambda is inversely proportional to under root m. Lambda will be inversely proportional to under root m. Now tell me out of these three particles, what is the mass? Electron, alpha particle and proton. What is the mass of electron? And mass of electron you will have to find out in AMU, AMU, atomic mass unit. So, mass of electron in terms of AMU is very small and it is 1 upon 1837 AMU. The mass of alpha particle is 4 AMU and the mass of proton is nearly equal to 1 AMU. So, what is the heaviest particle among these three particles? That is alpha. After alpha, lighter one is proton and the lightest particle is electron. And since lambda is inversely proportional to mass, so the heaviest particle will have lowest wavelength. So, the wavelength of electron will be higher than that of wavelength of proton and it is more than that is wavelength of alpha particles. So, this will be your correct order in decreasing order. You can understand again and again because this is one of the most important things. An alpha particle, an electron and proton is having same kinetic energy. So, arrange them in order of its decreasing order of wavelength. So, for that you will have to find out the mass and from the expression you have find out the wavelength is inversely proportional to under root of mass. So, much more will be mass, less will be wavelength and from this you have got the lowest value of wavelength for electron than that of proton and alpha particle. So, this is some example related on this wave nature of matter and related to this we will discuss in next lecture about Sommerfeld atomic model. And this is based upon the failure of Bohr's atomic model. So, we will discuss this part in next lecture. You will have any queries regarding this, you can write down your comments. Whenever you will find this video, you can ask any question regarding this wave nature of matter in the comments, you will get the answer for this. Okay? Thank you very much and we will discuss the another part in next lecture. Thank you.